by Sam's way that he was creative, which meant sometimes he was.
Did he separate the workshop space, but he also had separate studios in Santa Monica? He was in the short name of the Motion Art District, and he had.
Rare and unusual in looking back at the community that Sam created. Respected each other's realm.
Oh, just that is in sandbox playing and stuff like that, yeah. And, you know, my dad would also encourage us to draw our dreams, you know, because that was our dreams are unconscious. And so, and the stories had, now that I look back on it, a very Jungian kind of psychological, spiritual spin to them, or angle to them, or theme to them, maybe that's the right word. Because there was like in, one of the characters was the shadow man, you know, and the shadow man, you could only, you know, there's the shadow in Jungian psychology, but in this story that we had, that we created together, the shadow man was just the, you know, grateful that he opened me up to all those different psychologies, look into what's going on in your unconscious and all that.
He immersed himself in Japanese culture. And and this student, and so, you know, in the old tales of like Zen masters and their students, if we would be compatible in terms of working together. So I think the fact that he would always say, I come to the studio, I mean, this would happen, like, right? If you're, we never work, we'd be like, your questions, and everything, we're going to get to work. Then I'd get there, and he wouldn't be there. I'd wait for 3 or 4 hours.
Dark and light, but up and down. I mean, you might be stuck for a while. appreciated, and I think everyone around there appreciated, was